Hey guys, Paisteboy here. Today we're going to be installing my Chatterbox X2 Slim P communicator on my new oxygen helmet, so stick around. All right, let's take a look at what we need here. Obviously you need the communicator. I've already have this installed in another helmet, so I just bought this accessory pack here to install it into a second helmet. That way I can use it on both. And this comes with speakers, full face microphone, and open face microphone. And then I've got some screws and two spacers because the oxygen helmet, although you could put it on the oxygen helmet without them, but that will squish the little plastic part on the edge of the helmet. So rather than do that, these screws and spacers will make a big difference to keep it nice and flush and flat without crushing the lining of the helmet there. And of course, you need an oxygen helmet. So let's see what comes in the accessory pack. I actually bought this over a year ago, but there was a back order on the oxygen helmets, so I had to wait until I could get my hands on one. All right, so in this bag, we've got the two speakers, a boom mic, and a regular mic. So we're going to be using the regular mic. And you'll see on the back, there's a little white dot. Pay attention to that. So we'll put the boom mic back in the bag. And then in this other bag here, we have two more components, the original screws that it comes with, and an Allen key, which we will use. And these are the parts that go inside the helmet. What those spacers are going to do is it's going to allow us to have this inside the helmet with some space between it so it doesn't crush the helmet. It'll sit nice and flat instead of crushing it, and then it's going to want to sit on an angle. And then I'll tell you at the end where you can get these screws. In this bag, we just basically have a microphone clip, which this one, I don't even know if that's for this model, but we won't be using that anyway. And then we've got some round Velcro. We got some little Velcro, square Velcro, but basically assortment of Velcro to attach the speakers and the microphones. So we'll set those aside for now. And the first thing we're going to need to do once we set this all aside is take the chin curtain off of the helmet. So one thing I just wanted to show here with the oxygen helmet that I didn't know about the other day was there's a little sticker in here that says peel off. You could only read it from the inside, and from the outside it just looks like a little white sticker. And I peeled the sticker off, and then I noticed this little cellophane type plastic there that was coming off, and I was worried that I damaged the helmet, but apparently you have to remove this or otherwise you're just gonna have a blurry screen. But I was a little worried there for a second before I realized that this had to come out. So be sure to remove that. And by the way, thanks, Greg. Flip the helmet over and we'll start removing the chin curtain here. So we're gonna start pulling here. There's some clips in the front, clips on the side that come out. They obviously come off a lot easier than they will go back on. And so there's the chin curtain removed. So I'm kind of torn whether I want to use these with the speakers or not. but I think I'm going to. And if I don't like these in the helmet, it can always be taken out and just Velcro the speakers right inside without these. So let's take these two out of the helmet. And there's a little hole, and there's a little hole here, and that goes up in the helmet. So we'll set the helmet aside for now, and we'll take these apart. So I guess you just stick your finger in there and kind of press it through until it comes out of the little earmuff here. And then we've got this portion here that'll come apart. And you can see on the inside here, there's another piece of foam and a circle cut out. So we'll take the little piece of foam out of the middle. So we'll take this foam out. Okay, put that back. And we'll do the same with the other one. There we go. You know, you want to muscle it, but at the same time, you don't want to break this thing. So all right, and here's the second one. Take that foam off, and we'll do the same thing with this one. All right, there it is, and that goes back in there. This goes back here, and then all we have to do is get our speakers. So let's assemble the speakers into the noise canceling earmuffs. So this is one speaker. It's got a Velcro side and a non-Velcro side. The non-Velcro side is the speaker. And since this is the side that sound is going to come out of, we want this facing up and the speaker facing that way underneath this foam. It probably doesn't really matter because the foam is so thin, but we'll put it like that anyhow. So wrap that foam around that speaker with the cord coming out. And then you're gonna look for the little hole. It says top, and we're gonna make sure that this is on the top there. And the wire coming out of the bottom. Looks like there's a little notch here. We'll put that through that notch. That might help. Now this is the right side speaker. So I think we'll try starting from the side and spin it a little bit to get it to the top. And then we'll push from the bottom up and try to get this in there. Definitely going to have to mess around with these things. And they don't look like them. It doesn't feel like it's a very flexible material. It's definitely thin and, you know, you can work with it, but it's not going to stretch. So got to be careful not to tear it. Now you could also opt to not use these earmuffs at all. The helmet won't be as quiet, but it'll still be quiet. I mean, it's a very airtight helmet. And I do know someone that you may know, Duke. He didn't use these earmuffs when he put his communicator in his oxygen helmet. So I've got this one fully installed, and I will fully admit that was not fully fun. So get ready to finagle with it Just gonna have to find a way to stretch it, pull it. I was at the point where I almost didn't care if I ripped it because it just didn't feel like it wanted to go in. But I kind of started manhandling it a bit and got it to go on without tearing it. You got to kind of get your fingers in underneath and push this around. So let's see if we can do any better on the second one. So again, it'll go like this. So you have to put the speaker in like so. And then flip it over so that the NCS logo is showing, and that says top with the wire coming out from the bottom. And we'll try that again. Now this doesn't matter which way, I suppose. There's four little vents in there, but whatever. So let's get this started. All right, and we'll kind of push from the bottom and then get your finger in there. All right, I finally got them, and I'm not gonna lie, this was not fun. This is the left side of the helmet. This is the right side of the helmet. This is the side the communicator is gonna go on. So we gotta get our short speaker. This is our long speaker, so we'll get the other one, the short speaker. Find your hole that says top and put that on this side, the left side where the communicator is gonna be. And then take your other speaker, find your hole, face to the top, and press that into the Velcro there. Now we're gonna want to get all the wires to this side of the helmet since the communicator's here, and this, there are little snaps in here, so we're just gonna pull that out, and we're gonna take this part of the wire, and we're just gonna put it beneath that snap. And we'll take the next one out over here, and we'll fish that behind there, like so. Hopefully you can see that. I know it's a bit tight, but these are just little simple snaps. Okay. And then kind of fish it back here. There's two snaps, and we'll put them beneath those two snaps. Okay, so now we're on this side of the helmet, and we're gonna have to come out here. Hopefully we have enough length to do that. So here's our cord to plug into the helmet. Here's our cord to plug into the communicator for the headphones. Just gonna see, we've got a little extra on this one. I'm gonna try to make them more even. I'm just gonna push that back like that. All right, oops, there we go. Okay. Now we're going to install the actual communicator bracket. So grab this here, and with the U-shaped part facing outward, we're going to slip that in here. And you got to make sure that it's in front of that little red tab there, because that's where you're going to need to snap the chin curtain back in. So we'll wedge this in here, and then as long as it's in front, or I should say behind, the red connector, will be all right. So we'll take this part of the communicator connection, This is the side that the communicator actually snaps into, but since we're looking at the helmet upside down, we're going to put it on in this orientation, so it kind of just sits here like a ledge. All right, and now we'll put our two little screws in. These are the ones from McMaster Car that I'm going to tell you about at the very end of the video. And your two little spacers from McMaster Car that I'm going to tell you about at the very end of this video. And then get this in there. And start one of them. And I'll turn it around so you can see what I'm doing here. And then the other one. Hopefully you can see that. I know this is kind of a really odd angle, but there we go. I can't even see what I'm doing here. Maybe I should bring the light a little closer. Yeah, how's that? Better? All right, so get this started here. And just tighten them by hand. And now that we've got it, you know, together, we can get the exact final placement, which looks perfect right there. So let me get the little wrench and we'll start tightening this up. And since we put those spacers in, essentially, we're just going to bottom it out on those spacers and then we're done. I'll leave a link below if you want the spacers. Let's see how that communicator goes on. Just fine. Push the tab back and lift up, and it's off. Let's install the microphone now. So I'm going to put it in the middle here. All right. Now, before we connect the microphone, we're going to install it on the communicator housing here. So there is a little notch down here, and there's a corresponding one on the microphone. So you just got to line that up and plug it in all the way. And then, like I said, the little white dot on this microphone has to be facing your mouth. So we're going to get the little Velcro for this and put it in there. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take the little sticker off of this. I've got this bigger backer, and that'll just give me more versatility of where to put it if I want to move it after the fact. So I take the little backer off the small one and stick it to the back side of the microphone first. Then I'm going to peel this off of there and we'll stick it right down here. Hopefully you can see that right there. Hopefully it's not too low. But I think we'll be all right there. Okay, so I've already got it plugged in. That way we can get our chin curtain in place. So let's do that next. So we'll get these kind of up in the air a little bit. We'll have to put this microphone wire behind this snap. And I suppose we'll start in the back of the helmet since that's the easiest part to install as far as the chin curtain goes. Okay, and we gotta make sure these wires are in front of this snap here. Okay. I guess we'll start on this side since there's nothing in the way. There. It's not snapping in. Okay, there we go. I just had to pull it back a little bit further. Okay, we'll do the same thing on this side. I guess if you don't pull it back far enough, it won't go in. Probably want this wire on this side. Okay. Pull that back and try to get that snapped in. Now let's put some of these in and see if it'll line up better that way. All right, I got that chin curtain in. Not gonna lie, this was a big challenge. I think it's because the communicator makes this area so tight that it's hard to get this one clasp in. This side, same type of fastener, but nothing in your way, nothing, you know, impeding it, so it was easier to get in. So I'll show you here how I got the wires. It's the microphone. Goes straight inside. I don't know if you can still, you can't really see it too good there, but there it is. And then the communicator, got a little excess wiring out here, but not a whole lot we can do because of the way we had to route it out of here. And it was really tight. This cord barely reached. So we'll connect the communicator just to show you how it goes. And there it is. Ready to go. All right, guys, I want to thank you for watching. If you like the video, please give it a thumbs up. If you're interested in the link to the spacers and the different bolts there, you're going to check out Sometime Is Now. I'll leave a link down there. He made a great video on doing the same thing here. So thanks for stopping by, and we'll see you in the next video. Take care.